Our world is constantly changing. With the development of technology, our culture is also undergoing various changes. Together with the process of modernization, the culture from the West had also been brought to the Eastern countries. The local culture of the Eastern countries is bound to be impacted to a certain extent. How should the local culture be preserved and passed on?
In our 10-day trip to Gansu Province, China, our team, Yuan Ye Project from NUS, followed their ancestors' footprints and visited five cities. They are Lanzhou, Wuwei, Jiayuguan, Zhouquan, and Dunhuang. In this journey, we have focused primarily on looking for successes of intangible cultural heritage. Throughout the journey, we tried to understand their passion. We also recorded our thoughts by interviewing our members. There are different ways to pass down cultural inheritance. The successors now become a craftsman, owner of a private museum, a successful businessman, and most importantly, they are all students who learn from their ancestors, just like us. In this video, we invite you to begin a journey with us to revisit the successes of the intangible cultural heritage. And we invite you to always remember this journey and begin to learn something about our unique Singaporean culture and make it alive, just like these people. We arrived at the Gansu Fushun Folk Customization Museum, which consists of more than 20,000 collections of intangible cultural heritage recognized by the province.
为什么它说是黄河其实呢？因为黄河是在中国在兰州是唯一穿成而过的城市，所以这个黄河里面就保留了留存了很多精美的黄河奇石。但是欣赏这个黄河奇石，它有四要素，哪四要素？就是质、形、色、意。所谓的质就是质地，它是不是黄河石？形态它这个是不是有没有形状？色它上面有没有颜色？意它上面有没有意境？
The stone in the middle of the frontmost row was introduced as the show stone, for its pattern being similar to the Chinese character show, representing longevity. The one on the floor, on the other hand, is decorated as a turtle for its turtle shell-like texture. The museum holds a collection of 7,200 yellow river stones, each with a unique and symbolic pattern. The stone of Flying Apsaras is one of the most symbolic among the collections. The distinctive pattern of the celestial beings echoes with the murals in world-famous Morgao Caves, a UNESCO World Heritage Site also located in Gansu. In 2014, the Yellow River Stone was hailed as a National Intangible Treasured Heritage, representing a widely recognized appreciation of its treasured value. The exhibition area we headed to next exhibits the unique black porcelain of Agantang in Lanzhou. Black porcelain pottery is a traditional craftsmanship of Han Nation of China. A black porcelain Lusithus is also among the collections.
因为我们那个民俗文化里面有一个这个婚庆文化，就是结婚的时候，过去的人他要互相敬酒，就等于现在我们喝交杯酒，拿两个杯子就过去人家就拿着这个双喜瓶在喝酒。
这个就是油瓶，因为过去的油比较珍贵，不像现在色拉油好买。过去我们那个油都是菜籽榨的油，所以就是一说不定这只有半斤油吧，一家人要吃一个月，所以为啥带两个耳朵呢？因为过去老鼠多，把这个油用完以后，拿个石把它就吊起来了。
这个老鼠一定要把这油吐不走，你知道吧？再一个，有的人他就是把这放个碾子，把它点着以后，它就是个油灯，你知道吧？它主要就是这个用的。
In 2014, Mr. Yang Haijun was recognized as the representative successor for the intangible cultural heritage of black porcelain. Norfolk religion is an ancient religion with a distinguishing character of iconographic style. Nor masks are used in Norism ceremonies to drive away devils, disease, and evil influences, and also to petition for blessings from the gods. The art selected materials, colors, and applications of Nor opera masks vary among the regions, ethnic groups, culture, and aesthetic interests. That distinctiveness adds the mask's beauty.However, the inheritance of the carving skills is facing a great challenge in the modern days.
这个罗面啊，在过去，古人们它主要用于什么呢？就是祭祀、求雨，做一些这种法会的时候啊用的。但是过去的人他很保守，就是我这次用完以后，我把它就烧掉了啊。比如说，就说这个村子或者这个庄子会做罗面的只有这一个人啊。那时候好多东西他就。
Mr. Yang dedicated years of effort in the collection, research, and documentation of the Nor masks.
Gansu 有一个这个隆冬的这个就是亚太工艺美术大师叫王光普，他是在民间就是收集了很多的罗面的这个底稿，包括他自己也画。然后我们是为了把这个技艺传承下来，我们用了16年的时间，前后投入了10个人，刻了8000多幅这个罗面。为什么我们保护这个罗面的这个非物质文化遗产？因为它已经在这个断代了，就是罗面这个已经断代了。因为王光普大师已经去世了，所以他的手稿现在我们有4000多幅，这个罗面我们刻好的现在有8000多幅，在全国我们都是第一。
Since the 1980s, Norism has been worshipped in many regions of China till now, and numerous people like Mr. Yang are dedicating to protecting Asian cultures in their own ways. This marks the end of our visit to Fushun Folk Customization Museum.
对我来说，博物馆就是一座城市的记忆，它其实就像我们每个人的相簿一样，记录了我们不同时刻的点点滴滴。博物馆也是这样，它记录了一个地方、一个族群乃至一个文明是从何时诞生，又是怎样筚路蓝缕、百转千回的走到了今天。途中我们到底得到了什么，又丢失了什么，都一一镌刻在这个城市的记忆里。它给当代人提供了一种通往过去的镜子，通过与历史之间的对话，当代人能够或多或少在这样一个快节奏的、碎片化的、略显浮躁的社会里面去重构自己的精神坐标。吃习惯也是身份认同、文化认同的一部分，比如说我们都知道四川人喜欢吃辣，然后兰州有牛肉面等等，而饮食习惯往往与当地的自然环境和经济发展等因素息息相关。从食物中我们能够看到一个地方的历史和人文特点，比如说四川这样一个盆地，它是气候很湿润，所以我们很喜欢吃辣。又比如说兰州地处西北，比较缺水，所以面食比较多，牛肉面也就比较有名。兰州牛肉面有个标准，就是一清、二白、三红、四绿、五黄。一清是指汤清，二白是萝卜白，三红是辣椒油红，四绿是香菜蒜苗绿，五黄是面条黄亮。而许多经典的美食背后都有一个特殊而有趣的起源，其蕴含的文化故事是我们窥探当地传统文化和历史的一个镜像。但同时，美食在流传的时候往往可能需要加以改良以适应当地人的口味。其实在中国各个地方我们都会听到兰州拉面这一个称谓，但是当我们真正到兰州当地与当地人交流的时候，我们会发现，当我们说兰州拉面的时候，他们是一脸的诧异， 因为他们只听过兰州牛肉面，没听过兰州拉面，而兰州拉面其实是一个青海人开的，所以与兰州其实并没有什么样的关系。但我们看到的是什么？是这样一个兰州牛肉面这样一个 IP 真正的走向了全国，它在途中可能牺牲了一定的权威性和一定的传统的这样一个真实性，但是它更倾向于与当地人的口味相结合，它在适应性和广泛性上就做得更好。那么我们在传承和保护传统文化的时候，去怎么来处理这样一个传统和权威与适应和广泛之间这两个东西的取舍，我觉得是一个很值得我们思考的问题。因为当你一味的去强调权威和传统的时候，可能大家会觉得不感兴趣，但是当你一味的去想适应当地人的口味，去一味的去追求广泛的时候，可能就失去了其中的文化内核。所以我觉得这样一个饮食的讨论也是对文化传播的方式有一定的借鉴的意义。
This day, we came to the Gansu Pukang Wine Group located in Wuwei. Guiding the tour was the CEO of the Pukang Group.
关于酒厂，我们知道，普康五酒是源自于，传承于西夏文明。您能不能具体说一下它的历史以及它的特色？
对，这个我们现在的五酒呢，最大的两个特色啊，一个特色呢就是它的酿酒工艺。这个酿酒工艺呢，我们现在可以从，这个莫高窟啊，莫高窟的这个榆林窟里边一幅酿酒西夏酿酒图，可以来归属一个得出一个结论。包括我们开的国际西夏这个论坛也好，包括大家都专家得出一个结论，就是，最早的蒸馏酒就是从凉州这个地方，从西夏开始，啊。所以这样子的话，我们找到这个元素以后呢，我们当然这个酒厂本身60多年啊，那我们也是以这个考古啊、历史资料啊来传承最古老的那种酿酒方式，就是传承了比较古老的西夏酿酒的工艺。
Chinese liquor, a very popular fermented alcoholic beverage, is one of the oldest distilled liquors in the world.Chinese liquor fermentation is a unique complex process under solid-state conditions. After fermentation and distillation, the liquor is aged to remove compounds unpleasant to enjoy and bring out a complex flavor. In the modern days, this process takes place in a wine storage warehouse.
这边有叫什么柳树条、柳条边的，这边呢有白辣条、白辣条边的，白辣条边的，还有呢什么以后各地方它是因地制宜吧，有些地方有藤条边，有些地方有什么呀，有竹条边，边的这种酒海，我们叫酒海子，也叫酒笼子。那么以后好多人进来以后一看，说是这里面是不是还有一个陶坛，或者这个笼子里面是不是还有一个容器？那么实际告诉大家没有，这个容器呢是咱们国家的一个什么呀？非物质文化遗产，这是我们国家一个就是专门储存酒的一个容器。这里面呢拿的是一种纸，桑皮纸裱糊出来的。桑皮纸呢就是大家都知道以后这个桑树啊，桑树常吃的那个叶子，那个桑树的皮做的一种麻纸，毛纸就是一种手工纸啊，一层一层裱糊起来，大概要裱糊100多张厚，就是1公分多厚。用的这个胶水呢就是动物的血，牛血、羊血或者是猪血啊，这个一层一层裱糊起来。那么咱们的老祖先呢，不知道，他说是这个东西，反正是这么做，就不漏酒，不剩酒。那么现在呢，通过现在以后研究才发现，那么以后咱们的这个动物的血液里面有一种什么蛋白，有一种蛋白，溃合以后，咱们酒里面的酒精成分发生一个反应，形成一种胶体物质，这个就不漏酒了。
Inheriting from the wine culture of Gansu, Pukang Group worships the traditional Xixia craftsmanship also in the making of containers and drinkware.
我们所使用的酒瓶、酒具，包括我们的饮酒的酒杯、分酒器等等的，全都用西夏陶瓷。当时这个西夏国呢，这个首都是在宁夏银川的兴庆府。那府都陪都是在凉州， 啊。这样的话，我们有在凉州这个地方发现了这个西夏官窑啊遗址。这个西夏官窑遗址呢，有出土了一些西夏官窑所这个剔花瓷的一些文物，而且最有代表性的就是手工剔花雕刻，用西夏剔花手工剔花雕刻的工艺来做我们的酒器、酒具、酒瓶。
This is the manufacture line of porcelain in Pukang Group. Black porcelain, as its name implies, was made from a dark paste that had to be fired at high temperatures. The carved part exposes the color difference between the fatal color and the glaze color to play a decorative role. Xixia porcelain, as an important part,of Xixia culture, shows a rough and simple style with strong Tangut characteristic. With the involvement of local enterprise like Pukang, we are confident that the preservation of traditional art will be optimistic.
Before, every time, 仿佛都会与一些特定的意象联系起来，我觉得这些都是源自于我们从小接触的文学作品或者是影视作品的熏陶，比如说诗中所描绘的那种边塞苍凉的风光，将士们疆场杀敌，再比如神秘而遥远的西域，还有连接古代东西方文化和商贸的丝绸之路，这些意象它始终对于我来说还是很抽象吧。来到甘肃之前，感觉一切其实都虚幻而飘渺，直到双脚真正踏上这样一片土地，我才突然觉得，哇，原来这就是大西北的开阔，原来这一切的历史与文化都真真切切的发生过，就在这样一片广阔的土地上。张掖的七彩丹霞和敦煌的雅丹地貌，这两大奇观对于我们所有人来说都是一种极大的震撼。丹霞地貌的岩石各种颜色呈条纹状分布，层次分明，有那么一瞬间感觉自己像是在电影里的火星上。而雅丹地貌则是像屹立在浩瀚无际的戈壁滩中的一座魔鬼城，在这里个体上你能找到形态各异的岩石，只要你有足够的想象力，这里真的什么都有。而整体上呢，俯视排列整齐的一座座雅丹，它们像是远航的舰队，气势磅礴，穿行在这样的景色中间，仿佛像是穿越了时空，和古代的商队或是边疆的将士们并肩前行。我现在都还记得当时同行负责摄影的同学的一句感叹，他说我们人类不配拥有这样的景色。
We arrived at the workshop for Yugu embroidery, located in the Sunan Yugu Autonomous County of Gansu. The Yugus are a Turkic and Mongolic group, and one of China's 56 officially recognized ethnic groups. Being the home to over 90% population of the Yugu ethnic group, Sunan is the only autonomous county of Yugu in China.The Yugus are well known for their representative embroidery techniques in traditional costumes.
我们这个老传统的做法，它就是用纯棉的布，然后粘在一起，然后最上面粘一层这个纯色的这个缎子，然后上面把我们自己剪好的花贴在上面，就像我这样，像我这样，我这是做了一半。
Yugu embroidery.Has accepted both the in-island embroidery concepts and the characteristics of its own nation, and formed its unique charm over time. Although the techniques of Yugu embroidery are rather simple, few of the young generation are proficient or interested in this art. The demonstrator, who learned her techniques from her grandmother,
is officially recognized as the representative successor for this intangible cultural heritage. According to the demonstrator, the distinctive flat red hats or woven hats in female costume are said to be in memory of a murdered heroine in the history of the nation. The red tassel ears represent the blood on her head at the time of her sacrifice. Members tried on the traditional costumes of Yugu. As nomadic people living in the Gobi, the costumes of Yugu are cold resistant and sandproof. The Yugu language belongs to the Aztec language family. However, as the nation does not have a written language, the inheritance of the Yugu language is only through the word of mouth.
你好就是三十了。三十了。三十了。就是你好的意思。三十了。过年好就是过年好就是阿盖十了。阿盖十了。阿盖十了。阿盖十了。阿盖十了。阿盖十了。阿盖十了。The
Uyghurs clung to their traditional steppe culture for centuries and did not settle into farming oases. However, a large proportion of the Yongs now choose to become migrant workers in cities. Few young people are willing to do handcrafts such as embroidery due to the simple but boring nature of the work. The demonstrator is just a representation among those who are struggling to preserve these central aspects of Yugu culture, even as the traditions fade among younger residents.
从这次的刺绣的体验以及和老师的接触中呢，我发现其实玉姑族的刺绣本身难度并不高，主要手法也并没有那么的高深，同学们上手呢也立即就可以做。然而它却拥有着深厚的文化意义。我印象中最为深刻的吧，就是几乎所有的玉姑族的服饰呢都有其背后的故事，就像是比如说它那个红缨的帽子，象征着玉姑族的一位女英雄的鲜血，然后有一件装饰着很多那种大片白色饰物的饰品，则象征着他的脊椎骨等等。啊，从这个里面我可以深切的认识到，就是玉姑族的传统文化本身是十分有魅力的，而且我更相信本族的年轻人一定比我们更加了解本族文化的魅力。然而现在玉姑族的刺绣却面临着一个断层的问题，我认为其中主要的原因是传承这样一件事情的话，需要日以继日的去重复简单而又单调的一件工作。但是现在的年轻人在诸多的外来文化还有现代文化的冲击下，很少有人能有这样的耐心去把一件冗杂的事情给做下去。我在中四的时候学过一门课叫中华文学，里面多次都提到新加坡老一辈的华族人对于新加坡传统文化日渐式微还有西风东渐这么一个趋势的担忧。在这一点上，玉姑族文化的传承和新加坡的传统文化的传承我觉得有着相似的境遇。我认为同样作为高度全球化的社会，中国和新加坡所面临的共同问题就是如何去处理外来文化和本族文化之间的关系。外来文化尤其是西方文化，在很多时候我觉得是代表着先进，代表着现代化，有很多值得我们学习的地方，也是一个深度参与全球化的社会所必须经历的。但是同时 西方文化的强势侵袭对于本土文化造成了不同程度的冲击，甚至是威胁到了本土人民的文化认同和身份认同。然而，我觉得身份认同和文化认同对新加坡而言是至关重要的，它也是凝聚新加坡人的载体之一，也是新加坡保持独立自主的根基之一。那么我觉得我们应该如何去捍卫本土文化，让传统文化以为现在生活现代的生活所服务的方式焕发出一个新的生命力，就是我们两国人民都应该思考的一个问题了。
After the visit to Miss Bai's Yugu Cultural Studio, we visited another craftsman's art center. Just before the trip, we were amazed by the flying asparagus paintings and sculptures, which over 200 of them were repaired and maintained by sculpture master Du Yongwei. Du Yongwei has been engaged in Dunhuang sculpture for 40 years. Today, 59-year-old Mr. Du still maintains his daily routine of looking for red willow on the Gobi beach to make sculptures, molding shapes, and applying color. He takes the trouble to tell each visitor the production process and culture of Dunhuang color sculpture. Painted sculpture art is a traditional art form in Dunhuang, and the craftsmanship has been inscribed in the Provincial Cultural Heritage List of Gansu. Du, as a third-generation successor, now also opens up an institute to train students. He uses the traditional craftsmanship to replicate the sculptures in 1-to-1 ratio from dry grass and a special mud. His work has turned the 2,000-year-old cultural heritage vivid and alive again, which continue to attract a new generation of visitors. Since 1977, Du's life and Mogao grottoes were inextricably linked. Under the guidance of Sun Jiyuan, the director of the Fine Arts Institute of the Dunhuang Research Institute, Du has inherited completely the craftsmanship of Dunhuang colored sculpture. He has made more than 100 sculptures for the Dunhuang Research Institute alone. Du's work stands proudly as some of the most prominent masterpieces in the long list of Dunhuang culture. 40 years since he started the work, Du has become a figurehead in China's greatest craftsmen. Our visit to his studio was also the last stop of our trip.
Hello, 大家好，我叫王正乐，我是本次活动的创始人。在十天九夜的旅途当中，我带着16个 NUS 的学生从兰州到武威，到张掖，到嘉峪关，最后来到敦煌，最后从敦煌回到兰州。本次项目的意义呢，我想从两个角度来讲。先从我个人的角度讲起，我是甘肃兰州人，从小就来到新加坡接受教育。我始终记得小的时候，爷爷经常给我讲我的祖先如何当年跟随左宗棠来到大西北驻守边疆。对我来说，本次项目是一场珍贵的寻根之旅。在这次旅途当中，我带着大家重新踏上先人的足迹，重新触摸古建筑里厚重的历史气息，重新审视自己如何传承家乡的传统文化。在这次项目中，我带领15个新加坡国立大学的同学跟我一起重走丝绸之路，也是为了让他们以国大的年轻人的视角亲自体验一下丝路之美，同时把这个过程用影片的形式记录下来，通过借鉴甘肃这边对丝路文化的保护和传承的经验，从而给更多的本地国大学生以启发，应用在新加坡本土的传统文化的保护工作中。我们可以看到甘肃的各行各业分了四个方面来解决丝路文化传承的难题，他们分别是黄河骑士馆的私人收藏家、肃南裕固族的民族文化产业园区、普康集团传统酿酒工艺和现代商业模式的结合，以及敦煌雕塑大师的艺术保护工作室。这也就告诉我们，无论处在什么样的岗位中， 我们都可以为传统文化的传承出自己的一份力。那么作为国大的年轻人，在拥有全球化视野的同时，也不能忘记对新加坡本地传统文化的保护与传承。我们真诚的希望通过这部影片，我们可以让更多人，尤其是年轻人，踏上新加坡传统文化保护的道路，也希望新加坡的传统文化能够得到更好的传承。